Hi there, my name is Dr. Jeremy Jones from radiopedia.org, and today we're going to be looking at the ossification centres in the elbow. Elbow radiographs are often seen as complicated and difficult to report, and this is partly because of the number of ossification centres that develop around the elbow in childhood. Elbow trauma in paediatric patients is common, and being confident about whether the elbow ossification centres are normal or not is key to accurate diagnosis. In this video, we're going to teach you the mnemonic CRITOE as a quick and simple way to remember the order of ossification centre appearances. We're going to look at a series of normal cases, and we're also going to look at two abnormal cases to put our knowledge into practice. One of the great things about CRITOE and the elbow is that the ossification centres appear in a very reliable order. There is, however, great variability in the timing of the ossification centre appearances. If we imagine them on a timeline throughout childhood, the age range can be quite dramatic. In particular, there is quite a marked sex difference, with girls developing their ossification centres up to 2 years in advance of boys. Despite this timing variability, it is worth having a rough idea at what ages the ossification centres appear. To do this, there are two common counting methods. The first, which is probably the more reliable of the two, are the ages 1, 5, 7, 10, 10, 11. The second method, which is far more simple to remember, are the ages 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. Since there is such variability in the timing at which the ossification centres appear, we're going to use the simple version. So let's take a look at what each of the letters in CRITOE stand for. C is for capitellum, which is the first ossification centre to appear at around age 1. You can see it here in this child. The second ossification centre to appear, R, is for radial head, appearing at around age 3. This child has not yet developed a radial head, but if we switch to a slightly older child, we can see here a radial head ossification centre developing in its normal location. The third ossification centre to appear is I, the internal epicondyle, appearing at around age 5. At this point, it's worth remembering that the ulnar aspect of the elbow is the internal or medial side, while the radial aspect is the external or lateral side. This child has not yet developed their internal epicondyle ossification centre, so if we switch to a slightly older child, we can see it here, overlapping the distal humerus, which is typical of the internal epicondyle. The fourth ossification centre to appear is T, trochlea, appearing at around age 7. This child does not have it, so we'll switch to a slightly older child, and you can see it here, superimposed over the ulna. The fifth ossification centre to appear is O, the olecranon, appearing at age 9, and we can see it here, superimposed over the distal humerus. The final ossification centre to appear is E, the external epicondyle, appearing at age 11. This child does not have an external epicondyle visible yet, so if we switch to an older child, we can see that the external epicondyle has appeared. Compared to the internal epicondyle, which tends to overlap with the humerus, the external epicondyle typically does not and sits alongside the humerus. So now we have the full complement of the CRITOE ossification centres evidence in this 11-year-old. We're now going to take a look at two abnormal cases to try and emphasise the importance of CRITOE. Here's a 12-year-old boy who's fallen whilst playing football. We can see that he has a capitellum, he has a radial head in its normal position, but the internal epicondyle cannot be seen in its expected location, despite the fact that the trochlea, the olecranon, and the external epicondyle are all present. The extra bone fragment here on the AP image, and here on the lateral image, represent the internal epicondyle, which has become avulsed and sits inferiorly within the joint. I'll just annotate and show you where that internal epicondyle should normally be sitting. The internal epicondyle is the most common of the ossification centres to become fractured and avulsed. And if you had to remember just one thing from this tutorial, then this is it. Internal before trochlea. If on an elbow radiograph in a child you can see a trochlear ossification centre, then you should always be able to see an internal epicondyle ossification centre. And if you can't, then you need to look very hard to find the avulsed bone, as in this case. Let's move on to our second case, which is a 3-year-old girl who fell off a slide. This is her AP elbow radiograph, and we can see that she has her capitellum in the normal location. At age 3, she's just starting to develop her radial head ossification centre. As expected, there is no internal epicondyle, there's no trochlea, and there's no olecranon. There is, however, a small bone fragment in the region where we'd expect the external epicondyle to develop. Obviously, this doesn't make sense, as the patient is only 3 and we wouldn't expect this to be seen until age 11. If we look on the lateral image, we can see a distal humeral fracture, accounting for the bone fragment. So again, this emphasises the importance of CRITOE, knowing that the internal epicondyle is going to be the third ossification centre to develop, not the external epicondyle. So there you have CRITOE, the mnemonic for remembering the order and the names of the ossification centres around the elbow. C for capitellum, R for radial head, I for internal epicondyle, T for trochlea, O for olecranon, and E for external epicondyle. You can find out more on the radiopedia.org website.